The next thing I'll show you is going to be opening. So we're going to start putting a hole in the middle. The first rule of ceramics, if I didn't say it, is anchor. Anchor, always anchor. If you're not anchored, you're going to have a problem because our hands are basically like a lathe. Anything that you do with your hand is going to reflect on the clay. So if I push here, right, then you start to see that there's like a line that happens. Well, that's because I pushed there. So if anything weird is happening on your clay, it's because you put it there, not because it magically arrived. So just make sure you realize that whatever I do with my fingers, it's gonna reflect on the clay. When you put a hole in the middle, you're gonna need to make sure you're not going through the clay. So you're gonna take this, is a needle tool. And if you're throwing on a wheel like me, which probably most of you are not, you'll have to stop it with your feet. Just poke it into the bottom of the middle and then take your index finger, and your index finger is gonna go as far down as it can without pushing through the clay. You're gonna put your index finger on the needle and you're gonna pull it up so that you can see exactly how deep that is. So here's a little trick. The needle tool is a quarter inch thick. So visually I can tell how thick something is by figuring out how thick in relationship to this needle tool it is. So what I want is a half inch on the bottom so that when I'm throwing, I can basically trim a nice foot. So this is a foot right there on a vase that I made. So the foot is what keeps it up off the ground, and it kind of makes it look like it's floating. It kind of makes it look more pretty, more professional. All of mine have feet. A lot of ceramicists don't use them, but I like the way that they work. And for my assignments, I want my students to have them in there. So just make sure you have a half inch of clay on the bottom. So mine measured about this much, which if you took another needle tool, you would see it's about a half inch. Or if you take a ruler, because we want to be more accurate with what we're doing, then you should do that. If this small hole is too small, what you're going to want to do with your two thumbs is push down from the middle. Don't broaden them out, just put them right against each other and just push them straight in. Keep your hands on the side when you do it. So what I'm going to do is put more water. I'm going to use this sponge. This is an elephant ear sponge. And they're pretty rare these days and very expensive, so if you use a round sponge, it's fine. But these are like pretty nice to work with if you can find one. So I want you guys to imagine that your hand is a hand puppet. And this is a llama, okay? And the llama is on the left side, your left hand. See, L for llama, or for Laura. But anyways, so the llama is going to bite the clay from the inside. So this is his snout. I'm going to use his mouth, and it's going to eat the backside. See, the thumb is here. Now I'm going to put a sponge on his head, keep his ears up, and then I'm going to push some more water in and use my other hand the same way. The snout of my right hand is going to go on top and kind of pull the top of the left hand until it starts to open. And then what I'm doing right now is I'm evening out the inside back and forth. I'm bringing my fingers back and forth trying to get that bottom flat. Because once you start building up the sides and it gets thin, like kind of narrow, you're not going to be able to get your hand or any tools in there. So right now is the perfect time to flatten the bottom, and you can use this wood rib. That's what this tool is. Both hands on either side of it, holding it like this. And then you're going to anchor on your hips. You're going to push down in the middle and kind of just scrape along the bottom. You're not really going back and forth, you're just going on the right side if you're right-handed, the left side if you're left-handed, and just pushing down. What this is doing is it's one, flattening the bottom, but it's also compressing the clay, which is super important because in ceramics and clay in general, the only way it gets stronger is if it compresses. So even when it's in the kiln, the heat, the pressure that builds in the kiln is actually making that vitrification, we call it, happen, when it turns from just clay powder to an actual rock form. So the pressure pushing down on the inside of this is actually making that bottom stronger, so that when you go and you trim it later and then you fire it, you don't get an S crack in the bottom. What an S crack is basically where it's weak, and when it dried or when it was fired, there was too much pressure from it expanding or contracting from the drying process or from the firing process, and that causes your clay to split in the bottom. So this is gonna try to keep that from happening. I've had it happen anyways, but sometimes that's because I forget to take the water out of the bottom of my clay cylinder, so you don't forget to take the water out of the bottom of your clay cylinder when you're done, because you'll have problems then.